We are looking at class 10th, chapter 9, Societal Impacts of IT Solutions. Multiple choice questions, various questions we are going to take with respect to the societal impacts of IT, that is, you know, network security, virus, then backups, etc. The following is one of the stages in the life cycle of virus. So, virus is created, then it is assimilated, then eradication is done. So, all of these is the correct answer, D. Next is dash refers to the condition in which your computer stops working. So, when the computer stops working, we say my computer is hanged or it is hanged. This is the correct answer, A. Which of the following is not a form of virus threat? Which of this is not a virus threat? SSL. This is secure socket layer. While WOM, Trojan, malware, all these are type of threats. Which of the following types of virus affects the program files in your computer? So, because they are an infected file, we call them as file infectors. So, the A is the answer. Now, very short answer questions. What do you understand by hacking? Hacking is by some person or group of person who uses his IQ knowledge of computer science to break into computer to steal sensitive information. He is known as, or they are those hackers. And this process of stealing sensitive information is termed as hacking. Define spamming. See, you get in your inbox around 50 messages, only 2 are of your use. All those 48 messages, these are spams, which you don't want. So, spamming refers to the act of posting bulk messages to several users simultaneously by a known or an unknown source. Name different types of data backups. So, mainly, there are two main types of data backups. One is full backup and one is the differential backup. Why should you take backup of your data? See, when your computer or network goes off, means some with some problem, the data is the most important thing which you will think of. When your mobile actually it is lost or it is not working, you are only concerned about the contacts you had. So, to safeguard your data from being corrupted or deleted in case of any emergency like your theft or fire, you should take regular backups of the important data residing in your hard drive. Give examples of some popular antivirus software. There are so many. Some of these are Norton antivirus, McAfee, SmartCop, you have Avira, you have Kaspersky, you have QuickHeal, there are so many. Define online backup. What is online backup? Online backup, that means your system is here, say in Delhi. You are sending it to, say, New York. And you are remotely backing it up. So, whenever there is a problem, say in Delhi or in New York, you can easily get the data or restore the data back. Short answer questions. List some ways in which viruses can enter your computer. So, there are so many ways in viruses can enter your system. First is if you open documents with as email attachment which are infected. If you download some infected wallpapers. If you try to install softwares which are already infected. If you attach infected external device like the CDs, the DVDs and the USBs which are already affected, and if you visit the dubious website, I hope you are understanding what I am meaning, dubious websites. What are the damages that a virus attack can cause to a computer? What are the damages? First of all, a virus attack can steal information, steal your sensitive data information. It can corrupt your documents. It can slow down your computer. Write a note on the differential backup. So, there are two types of backup. One is full. Means every time you backup the full amount of data from one machine to another machine or some device, storage device. Now, the differential is when you only backup those files which are just modified. Those only modified are to be changed or to be backup, because previously all these are not, you have not changed every file or every content. The differential backup is taken of only the data or files that are created or altered after the last full backup, only those files. So this differential backup taken almost immediately after the base backup, that is full backup after this, are generally smaller than the base backup. That is why they are created faster than the base backup. Now next is name some security provisions related to e-commerce. So e-commerce has to ensure certain things which are security provisions. First is privacy. Privacy, this implies that the information provided by the user, it must be secured from any other user. Integrity means the information which is sent by the user must not be tampered or altered. Authentication means the sender and the receiver of the information must prove their identity, to each other. Non-repudiation means once things are sent, the other cannot deny. Refers to the proof of the information was indeed received. What precautions can you take to prevent a virus attack on your computer? What you can do to prevent virus attack? First, just avoid temptation to open everything, click everything, to open email attachments and download the unreliable sources. Just resist your urge to double click everything in your mailbox. If you get anything unexpected or file attachment, send an inquiry email to the sender asking about what is the nature and the function of the file attachment. Installing a reliable antivirus scanning software and just not installing but updating it regularly, because viruses are coming every day. Major antivirus software vendors like the Symantec, the Network Associate, Computer Associate, Trend Micro, and they provide regular updates. Some vendors also offer a service that automatically retrieves update on your computer from the company's website. Install only licensed software, no pirated version, and scanning of file downloaded from the internet or other external resources should be done. And keep regular backups of your data. Cite some circumstances in which you can lose your data. How you can lose your data? So this is hardware failure. If a failure of some computer hardware device is there due to their lifetime or limited lifetime, some power surge, hardware failures like the corruption of your hard disk drive, this may lead to data loss. So during hardware failure, the data or the lost data can be restored from the backup. Accidental deletion or modification of data. If you accidentally delete some data, you can anytime restore the data back from the backup. Restoration of old version of a file. If you want some old version, then where it is? You might have deleted, so it is in the backup. Unauthorized deletion or modification of data. Somebody might have hacked or cracked. Now you don't have that data, modified it, so you can restore it through the backup. How is online backup beneficial as compared to other types of backup? See, in online backup, you are actually storing or backing up on a remote system. So in online data backup, you send your data to a remote server through the internet or remote machine through the internet. You can easily restore your data in case of data loss by connecting to the remote server or remote system. So this online backup is very convenient method for restoring the data, especially when you are like a businessman or always on the move, since it can be done from anywhere, any part of the globe. The advantages of online backup are, first of all, it costs less than other modes of backup. Then you don't need hardware like the CDs and DVDs or backup like this. So it saves you from trouble of maintaining and repairing hardware. It allows you to restore your backup from any location in the world anytime. And the security is also high. It provides a high level of security of your data, because the data goes in encryption form when it is sent on any network. And it keeps your data safe from threats such as theft, fire, earthquake, or other threats like the disasters, as the backup is stored on a remote server. Write short note on ethics. See, when you meet someone, you greet him. This is the ethics. When elders are there, you don't use slang language. So there are certain ethics in the society. So whenever you are on internet or a network on a computer, then there are certain etiquettes or netiquettes So ethics play a key role in your life or our life, be it at work or at home. So they are referring to the way we conduct ourselves in different circumstances of our life. So if you apply ethics to the world of internet, this means we are ensuring that our actions do not harm or cause any inconvenience to other online users. Or we can say that we must observe proper etiquettes and netiquettes on the internet. List some cases in which antivirus software does not protect your computer. See, antivirus software is for viruses, worms, Trojan horses, etc. So antivirus software cannot protect your computer against, there are certain cases. First, the software that you have deliberately installed, the antivirus is saying don't install, but you have deliberately installed, which may contain unwanted features, spam, antivirus cannot stop, online fraud and phishing, this very few antiviruses can stop. Hackers who break through computer security, the antivirus has nothing to do with this. Now let us see some long answer questions of the network part, network security, the societal impacts of IT. How does phishing take place? What happens? You open a bank website. The website exactly look like your bank, this website. So you enter your credentials, and one or two times you enter your credentials, it says that login password is wrong. And by the time you enter, it might have gone to the imposter. And then the actual website of the bank will come. Then you enter and you see, you think that nothing has happened, but the data has already gone. So phishing refers to a technique of obtaining the personal information like the login, password, credit card credentials of another person without his or her knowledge or even consent. So phishing normally takes place through emails, instant messaging. In phishing, an imposter sends an email or uses a website that looks like exactly genuine, to trick people into giving him in important information about them. For instance, the imposter may send an email which may appear genuine to you coming from your bank or something, pretending to be a representative of your company. So in the email, he may ask you to update your information online by clicking the specified link. So as you click the link, you may be redirected to some, fraudulent website where you are asked to enter important information about yourself. And you think that, okay, I am giving to the right people, right person, which can later be used for some cybercrime or fraud. How does antivirus software work? Antivirus software, which is installed in your computer, they works by finding out whether the virus that has attacked you in your computer is already known or unknown. So there are two conditions, known or unknown. So if it is known, if the virus is known, that one that has already been detected and it has some injection or antidote written for it, the software looks for virus signature, a unique string of bytes which is similar to the fingerprint that identifies the virus. Every virus has some fingerprint because virus is actually a program itself, and it removes it from your computer. Most scanning software are able to detect not only an initial virus but also several of its variants because the signature code usually remains intact. How about unknown viruses? So in the case of new viruses for which no solution or no antidote is there till now, the virus scanning software employs heuristics that look for some unusual virus-like activity on your computer. So if the program finds any unsuspected activity like sending email outside or doing, capturing CPU for longer, it quarantines the questionable program and then broadcasts a warning to you about what the program may be trying to do, such as it may modify the Windows registry. What do you understand by quarantining a virus? See, in a hospital, when someone has a disease which is communicable and very, very deadly, he is kept in another room, single room, where others should not get affected. This is quarantining. So quarantine means keeping the virus in some isolated places on your computer under strict vigilance so that it cannot do further harm or infect another computers. So if you think the program may be a virus, you can send the quarantine virus to the antivirus vendor where researchers examine it, determine its signature, name and catalog it and release its antidote. So if the virus never appears again, which often happens when it is poorly written, the vendor categorizes the virus as dormant or sleeping. what do you need to, or why do you need to install antivirus software in your computer? So as you're aware that viruses can damage your computer or access sensitive information from it. To avoid certain this kind of situation, you must install antivirus software on your computer. And not even this will work, you have to update this antivirus continuously. So without an antivirus, your computer will remain susceptible to virus attacks, and viruses are day by day, you know, every day thousands of viruses are coming. What do you understand by SSL? Secure socket layer. You have a web server and you have a browser. Now you are actually expecting something from web browser. How to ensure that this coming and going of data or transmission of data is secure? This is done through SSL. So this secure socket layer is a protocol which ensures the sensitive information that can be transmitted safely online. So it establishes an encrypted link between web server and the browser to ensure the security of information that is exchanged between these two. Today, millions of websites use this SSL to provide protection to their users. So you might have seen HTTP, you might have seen HTTPS. This S is nothing but secure socket layer. What are the main reasons that restrict users from performing financial transaction online? See, first is finance is very important. You know, everyone work hard to earn money. If by any mean the money, you know, is taken by anybody else, by some computer knowledge or something, then what you will do? Because this is the internet and the network is all over the world. So everyone is scared, because every time you see and you read in the newspapers or internet news that something has happened, this was hacked, this was cracked. It has been found that mainly two reasons restrict users from performing financial transaction online. First is the reluctance to provide sensitive information such as credit card details or bank account details because of security concerns. Then the desire of users to check the goods before purchasing them. This may also be the case. Write a note on information security. This information security, it's a very important, you know, it plays a very important role in the growth of e-commerce, because here you are trading, you are selling, you are buying. So it can be defined as a set of rules and regulations that allow the users to follow certain rules and guidelines online to ensure that the information they provide is not misused in any way. In other terms, information security implies protection of information from illegal access or modification. State the importance of taking a regular backup of your computer data. This backup or taking backup will ensure that your computer data is protected and can be recovered in case it gets corrupted, stolen or damaged. Match the following: worms, malware, spamming, virus. Please give some time to read them and try to match them. I'll give you the answer. Worms, these are malicious programs that can copy themselves on a computer. Malware, these are malicious software that is designed to interrupt ongoing computer operations. Spamming is act of posting bulk messages to several users. And virus, programs that may or may not self-replicate and damage your system or data. So these were a few questions and answers on a very important topic, that is the social or societal impacts of IT, information technology. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.